VMware has a really smart feature where you as a VMware administrator can enable this feature on CPU and memory. Stay tuned to find out the do's and don'ts for enabling this amazing feature for hotplug CPU and hotplug memory. Also, stay tuned to find out the limitations. Hello everyone, this is Ibrahim Qureshi and welcome back. This is session 14 of hotplug CPU and hotplug memory. If you have seen the previous videos, on session 11 I completed showing you the VM settings where we added I showed you how to add the CPU and memory. In this session, I am going to show you how we can increase the CPU and memory without even powering off the virtual machine. So let's get started. Today's agenda is prerequisite, how to enable these features, what is the hotplug CPU, what is hotplug memory, how to enable these settings. So let's get started. Prerequisite to enable the virtual machine has a guest operating system that supports memory hot add functionality. So it all depends on the OS which we are running on the virtual environment. If your OS supports it, then you can leverage this feature. And to be quite honest, most of the flavors, latest flavors, does support hot add features. For example, Red Hat flavors like CentOS, Fedora, and Red Hat itself, I have tested these extensively. They are supporting from the latest version, which comes from 6.5, CentOS 6.5 and above. And not to forget Microsoft servers, anything from 2012 R2, 2016, 2019 supports hot add and hot add CPU and memory. So with that in mind, obviously 2008 doesn't support it. Every time you add a CPU, you need to reboot it again so that it understands the CPU has been increased. So bear in mind, if you are running, if your environment has 2008, this feature will not be supported in that. The other prerequisite which we have is the virtual machine is using hardware version 7 or later, so it needs to be considerable amount of latest virtual machine. If you haven't done if you haven't got the latest version of hardware, in the coming sessions I will show you how to upgrade the hardware version to the latest version. And again, VM tools, there's a session coming, or I think I have recently done one on installing VMware tools. Actually, the previous version to this will be installing VMware tools, which will be session 13. So don't forget to watch that if you haven't seen it. So VMware tools are very important for performance and obviously features like these. To enable hot add, at least once when we for enabling this feature, you need to power off the VM and enable it. This can be scripted with power CLI, however we need to power off for the settings to take effect. So when I say scripted, we can run a script and enable this feature, hot add and hot add CPU, like a click. And what happens is the feature will be enabled, but you cannot actually start using it until you power off and power on. So some people can say, okay, I'll just patch the OS and give it a reboot and that should be it. No, it has to be a power off operation and a power on operation. Okay, with that in mind, let's move on. So prerequisite to enable, we are going to cover that again, how to enable this on CPU. So right click, edit settings, and then we go to the configuration where you have this down triangle facing down. It usually is facing the right, and you click on it, it drops down and then you see all these advanced features. Over here, as you can see, I have highlighted in red CPU hot plug, and you all you have to do, guys, is enable it. Now this feature is grayed out. You cannot enable this if the virtual machine is already running. So as I said, we need to power it, the VM off when you're doing this, when you're enabling this for the first time at least. And then after that, once it is done, then you can obviously, if you see any CPU contention, you can increase it on the fly while the VM is running. So VM settings, as I said, VMware settings, expand the CPU, and then that's where you get it. Okay, so hot plug memory, power off to enable, as I said, and then what we do is expand this again, and then you'll find memory hot plug, and then we basically enable this feature. Limitations, this is the important bit which I was telling about. In regards to memory, we have to remember that if we have given a virtual machine a memory below 3 GB, so if you have a 2 GB memory, you can increase it to 3 GB. You can obviously increase it from 2 to 3 GB, and then after that you'll get this option grayed out, because it's a limitation of the ESX host that you have to have the memory at least 4 GB or above to be able to leverage hot add memory, hot pluggable memory feature. So if you're having a if you're already having it on 4 GB, that's great. If you are not, if it's below 4 GB and you think you might need to increase it above 4 GB, by all means try to make it a benchmark that you at least give a 4 GB as a minimum requirement, so that when you do have this enabled, you can always go in and increase it to 6, 8, whatever you want. As long as the host supports, you can increase it up to 64 GB memory, or even more if you want to. Well, you can go up to 256 or 1 TB if you want to, really. So it's up to you, as long as your host supports it. So the benefits again, let's cover the benefits once more. Benefits of hot add: increases CPU and memory resources on the fly while the VM is running. It does not require a reboot once it is enabled. So remember that for the first time, you still need to power it off and on. After it's done, you don't need to reboot it. You can increase the CPU resources on the fly. We will be going through demo. Hopefully, I'll show you a demo of hot plug CPU and hot plug memory in the next session. And if you want me to do a demo on Linux and Windows for CPU and memory, just comment on below and let me know. And then I will do the demo for you. Don't forget to reach out to me at Ibrahim Qureshi on Twitter. And that's my blog. I have already created the post for this topic on my blog. So don't forget to check it out. And today's question of the day: when we enable hot plug CPU or memory, hot plug memory, do we need to reboot the server or power off and power on the server? Let me know below in the comments, guys. And don't forget to subscribe. Enjoy watching and keep sharing. Cheers.